Hi, my name is Jeffrey Rubin from Testrite Instrument Company, Hackensack, New Jersey. Testrite is an OEM manufacturer. What does that mean? It means we make parts for your product. Today, we're going to talk to you about swivels. The video is going to be broken up into two sections. First, we're going to talk about swivel mechanisms. So these are parts that can be added to your project, your existing parts, to add a swiveling action. Second, we're going to talk about intrinsic swivels. What does that mean? It means we design swiveling action into a product, such as this, but without actually installing a swiveling mechanism. So we hope this video is helpful for you. So now we're going to talk about swivel mechanisms. Up first is our ball swivel. The ball swivel enables a restricted 360 degrees, go all the way forwards or all the way back, and there is a little bit of restriction on the left and the right. It can either have a knob or a carriage bolt. You can define the thread you want on the top and the bottom. The top and the bottom are automatic screw machine parts we make in-house. The sides are die-cast. In front of me, you can see this tablet holder is made with our ball swivel, so it allows you to adjust the angle wherever you need it. You can then use your wrench or your knob to tighten it in place. Our next swivel mechanism is our frame swivel. The frame swivel, as you can see, has preset positions. There is a female plate and a male plate, and when they line up, it will fix in a position, and then you can secure it either with a knob, or in this case, we show it with a aluminum puck that we manufacture in-house. I can show you over here on this frame how it's used. When it's loosened, you can adjust the frame into any of the existing fixed positions, and then by tightening on the puck, you can lock it in place, either straight up and down or at an angle. Up next is our tube end swivel. So this is a die-cast swivel mechanism, most often supplied with a knob. It goes into the tube size that you see on your screen, either on the outside or the inside. And then you use this knob to loosen, enabling you to hit a particular position, and then locking it. The positions are fixed based on the die-cast teeth. Now in terms of an example of our tube end swivels, you can actually look at the boom mic stand that we're using to film this video. Up next are one of our most popular swivel mechanisms, our U-bracket swivels. Now you can see there are two different types I'm holding. One allows you to pivot anywhere within 180 degrees, and the other one has fixed position points. We do have a die to punch these out at these points, but if you need different positions, which we've done in the past, we can do that without a problem. So let me show you how these are used. So this is an example of the swivel bracket with the fixed positions. So you adjust it to the position you want, then you can use your steel retaining pin. Now you could also use a bolt and nut if you want, and you're going to slide it into position. In this particular case, they want it so that each user can pick the angle that they want. And in this case, it's also attaching one of our telescopic tubes with a laser cut steel plate to the swivel bracket. Now this particular customer is worried about the users losing the steel retaining pin. So one option we offer, which they did here, is we can crimp a steel cable to attach the steel retaining pin to the plate and the U-bracket so that it will never be lost. Another way the U-swivel bracket can be used is to swivel two separate tubing assemblies. Here's another example of a swivel mechanism. We have an aluminum half cylinder attached to a telescopic tube. Attached to that cylinder is an aluminum block with an O-ring on either end. You loosen the knob, you can get to any angle you need with 360 degree movement, and then you tighten in place. And then you secure your apparatus with the puck. There are a wide range of applications where you may need a swiveling action, but you might not necessarily need a swivel mechanism. We're calling these intrinsic swivels. In front of me are a couple of examples. Know that if you need a swiveling mechanism or you need a swiveling action, send us an email or drop us an RFQ, request for a quote, and we're happy to get back to you and let you know what we think will work in your application. The simplest form of an intrinsic swivel is where we allow two pieces to rotate along a single axis. In this particular case, we show it with a rivet. You can also have multiple points of articulation, as shown here with one of our stampings. So we make the stamping in-house. So again, by using one rivet, you allow one piece to articulate vis-a-vis the others. An intrinsic swivel can also be created using two L brackets with a common thread and knob. This next example shows a whole other type of swiveling action, where two L's are allowed to swivel one over the other, and they tighten, again, with a knob. Here's another example of an intrinsic swivel, where we place a U-bracket underneath the frame, and then we have knobs on either end, allowing you to angle the frame, and then lock in whatever angle you want. In this particular case, we have high-strength neodymium magnets underneath the frame bracket. Here's another example of an intrinsic swivel. You have two aluminum extrusions, joined by a U-bracket, and then a leg stay that swivels into place. This die casting is another example of an intrinsic swivel. It accepts a center tube, which can either be allowed to free float or secured with a set screw, and then the other two tubes that go on either side can swivel freely. Testrite is a 102-year-old family business manufacturing in Hackensack, New Jersey. Whether you need a swivel mechanism you saw in this video, or another type of metal swivel action you didn't, please reach out to us, www.testriteoem.com, and let us know how we can help.